Hello everyone, I'm Brandon with Lenovo, and I'm here today with the ThinkStation P300 Small Form Factor Workstation. Today we are going to be replacing the internal storage drive. This process will take about 10 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. There are no tools required to do this. Before we continue, we need to make sure that we are protected against electrostatic discharge, or ESD. Make sure to shut down the computer and disconnect all cables and accessories from the system. For further information, watch our Understanding Electrostatic Discharge video by clicking the link in the description. Now that we're ready, let's get started. To remove the cover, we must first remove two thumb screws. Next, we're going to press the release button, slide the cover towards the rear of the system, and remove it. To open the drive bay assembly, we just need to press inward on the blue release button, swing the drive bay assembly up, and allow the lever to lock into place. Before removing the internal storage drive, we must first disconnect the SATA and power cables. Then we're going to grasp the rounded part of the bracket and pull the drive from the bay. Now we're going to remove the storage drive from the bracket. We just want to pull the bracket away from the drive until the pins exit the holes. Here we have our replacement internal storage drive. Now we're going to attach the drive to the bracket. We just want to assure that the pins on the bracket line up with the holes on the drive, and you may need to stretch bracket away from the drive a little bit in order to get the holes and pins aligned. Also, you want to make sure that the connector end of the internal storage drive lines up with this end of the bracket. When replacing the internal storage drive, we just want to align the drive with the bay and press inward until it locks into place. Then we just need to connect the power and SATA cables. When closing the drive bay assembly, we first need to lift slightly upward on the assembly, press inward on the release latch, and then swing the assembly down until the lever locks it into place. When replacing the cover, it's important that the tabs on the cover align with the notches in the chassis. You place the cover down onto the chassis, slide it towards the front of the system. Finally, we're going to replace two thumb screws.